today I am going to be doing a fun video that I thought you guys might get a kick out of in Battle Royale, as I'm calling it. And ultimately, what I'm going to be doing is breaking down these three popular, or maybe semi-popular, maybe not popular in the case of the 1911, who knows, handgun options in 9mm to help explain advantages, pros, and cons to all three of these handguns, and essentially place them into where they fit best. So what I mean by this is there's a best out of these three. There's a best shooter, there's a best carrier, and there's a best overall. And so I wanted to break that down and explain that, so that depending on what you're looking for or what you want to get out of a pistol, this video might just help you with that decision. So to start off, of course, if you're not a 9mm fan, or if you don't carry a 9mm, this video is still probably pretty useful to you, as most of these handguns, especially the 1911, are made in other calibers. And honestly, the opinion doesn't really change, because the size, it doesn't really vary that much. So without any further ado, let's jump into this. So let's start with the top shooter. Now, what do I mean by the top shooter? Out of these three handguns, what I mean by the top shooter is what gun out of these three is the most comfortable to shoot, the easiest to shoot, and has pros that lean more towards shootability. Now, I want you guys to understand that just because a gun is very shootable does not necessarily make it the best handgun, especially when we're talking about carry handguns, because by and large, the best handguns to shoot are usually the largest handguns with the least amount of recoil, so that way they're the most controllable. Unfortunately, trying to conceal a very large handgun is usually quite a task. So anyways, getting back to it, the best shooter here has to be, hands down in my opinion, the CZP-10C. And while it is in the compact range, it is definitely the largest of these three pistols. You guys can probably tell that already. And like I said, while it is classified as compact, it really is pretty sizable. However, that size mixed with a great trigger and great sights make it the easiest to shoot accurately and reliably. Now, it is pretty reliable, but what I mean by accurately and reliably, I mean that the gun is easy to get on target, shot after shot after shot. So you're hitting it your first shot just as well as you're hitting it your 10th shot, as well as you're hitting it your 16th shot. So the handgun is just round after round an easy gun to shoot, and honestly, as I've talked about in other videos, it is probably one of my most favorite handguns for recommending to a beginner who's looking for something that they think they want to conceal carry, and you know, they have the frame to conceal a P10C. It's probably the best gun to train on and learn how to properly shoot a handgun accurately, fast, reliably. So that for the best shooter out of at least these three, it has to go hands down to the P10C. And I would even say the best shooter out of multiple other 9mm handguns that I've shot. It is a fantastic shooting handgun, especially when we're talking about sub $1,000 and even sub $500 for the CZP-10C. Okay, so the best conceal carry, or the best carrier out of all of these. Now, when I talk about carry, I do specifically mean conceal carry. And the reason why I'm saying conceal carry is all three of these handguns are compact, or at least marketed as compact. This is a Springfield Range Officer compact. This is a CZP-10C for compact. And we all know the Glock 19 is compact. So these are all compact handguns. And when you buy a compact handgun, it's usually due to the premise that you want to conceal it. So that's why I'm talking about concealability. So that long-winded explanation out of the way, it goes hands down to the Springfield Armory Range Officer Compact. This is for a couple reasons. One, it's a single stack, so it is, you know, obviously thinner than a double stack, making it easier to fit inside your pants, easier to carry without really noticing it intruding on you. Now, you do feel it because it is a full metal handgun, but it's really honestly quite comfortable. The other reason I'm giving it an advantage is that the gun, when in carry, is very smooth. There's no sharp edges to really come up against. And honestly, whether I'm sitting, whether I'm, you know, standing, walking around, you know, oftentimes I honestly, and maybe unfortunately, spend a lot of time sitting, whether that's driving or whether that's just sitting at a day job, you know, I spend a lot of time sitting down. So having a handgun that's comfortable in multiple positions as I move throughout the day, and, you know, once again, sitting, standing, running, walking, whatever I do, it's really important for me to have a gun that disappears on me, or a gun that's so comfortable that I honestly forget it's there. Now, like I said, it is a little bit heftier than the other two polymer framed handguns because it is a metal framed handgun, but at the same time, you'd be surprised how well, so long as you have a good belt, that weight honestly disappears. Because the reality is, especially when you're carrying something inside the waistband, your body is supporting it, but really the belt is doing the majority of the work supporting that handgun. So honestly, whether it's this P10C or this Springfield RO Compact, I'm really not noticing much of a weight difference or really much of a burden difference in between the two. Now, obviously, I do realize that has something to do with the amount of ammo that this can carry over this, because this is a 8 plus 1 and this is a 15 plus 1, but it's once again not that nominal. And it's a very comfortable handgun. Like I said, it's reasonably thin. And honestly, what I like about it a lot is the fact that, and the reason why I'm giving it the top conceal, is that it's thin enough that it's realistically comfortable to carry, but at the same time, it also doesn't feel like you're holding a piece of paper when you do come time to draw it. In addition to this, just like a classic 1911, or maybe not so classic, but just like any modern 1911, it has a very clean trigger, and the sights, of course, are pretty great on it. So it's reasonably easy to get on target with and get hits with. As I've rolled into videos, you know, I pulled a 10 round mag out and got 9 out of 10 shots. Don't know why I missed my first shot, but the hitting reliably is pretty much there. I just wouldn't say it's a 15 out of 15 like the P10C. Okay, so that leaves us with one gun and one kind of nomination, the best overall. And that definitely is where I see the Glock. The Glock, in my opinion, is really the jack of all trades when it comes to handguns. It's not the cheapest, it's not the most expensive, it's, you know, not the easiest to shoot, but at the same time, it's not impossible to shoot. It's reliable and rugged as hell, and it'll take any bullet you put in it. You can shoot steel case out of it, you can shoot aluminum case, brass case, nickel plated case, whatever you want. This gun is just a monster. It will run everything, and truly, it's a gun that, in my mind, if I could really say, give it an award for like being the most rugged handgun, that's probably where I would go with this handgun, because it is incredibly rugged and it can take an absolute punishment and just keep coming back for more. It is one of my favorite handguns for that reason. Once again, it's also not the largest of the compacts, but it's also not the smallest of the compacts. I do realize that this Compact RO, or this RO Compact, is not the smallest of compacts either, but it is smaller than the Glock just by a tiny bit. And so certainly it is, the G19 is smaller than a CZ P10C, but once again, that smallness and the weird ergonomics of the Glock do make it a little bit more challenging, especially for first-time shooters who are not super familiar with the ergonomics, or if those ergonomics just so happen to not fit them right. I will say, in the defense of the Glock, I have had new shooters who have never shot a Glock a day in their life. I've taken them out to the range, and they've hit, you know, man-sized silhouette steel targets, you know, 12 out of 15 times at about, you know, 15 yards, which is pretty good for 15 yards, because a lot of people will talk smack, but when the target's out there, trying to hit it is another thing. So once again, you know, the ergonomics are not necessarily the best, but they're serviceable. And one thing that I do absolutely love about the Glock is, in my opinion, if you can learn to shoot a Glock and you can shoot a Glock accurately, fastly, reliably, it's what it will teach you through learning to shoot it will make you a better shooter when you go over to something like the CZ P10C that has a better trigger, that has better sights, or same thing with the Springfield RO over here, you know, is better trigger, better sights, and when, like I said, if you can learn how to shoot this trigger, this stock Glock trigger, you will learn, or you will be able to shoot other rounds with much higher levels of confidence and with much greater ease. So honestly, there's a lot of variables when it comes down to concealed carrying, but these are just a little bit of what I've learned, and hopefully this helps you guys and adds some insight. At the end of the day, if you asked me, you know, if I could only live with one of these guns, or would I ever sell any of these guns? So at the end of the day, if you asked me, you know, am I going to sell any of these guns here? No, I still love all of these handguns. For me, even though a lot of the niches that these fit into are very similar, I still have dedicated purposes to them. I still love this gun as an outdoors gun, even though it is a 9mm. You know, if you're not going up against bears, this is a fantastic handgun. You know, this gun fits into a lot of purposes, and once again, it's super rugged and reliable. And this is an excellent appendix carry handgun for me. So, I love them all. I have purposes for all of them. And at the end of the day, they're all staying in the collection, so they all must be good for something. Anyways, guys, that's all for now. God bless, and I'm out.